Hey guys, how's it going? So this video is yet another video in which I kind of read aloud, not kind of, but actually do, read aloud a message I wrote to someone. A YouTube user and I have been kind of having back and forth email conversations, and this was one of my reply. This is not a reply to what he said to me, but I just kind of sent him a message saying, like, here's something to think about. So I just sent him a new message saying, these are my questions to you. And this is what I wrote to him. Now that we pretty much established each other's positions, you know, I'm an atheistic humanist, you're a Christian, I think I'd like to ask you a few questions of my own. And this is the question, actually, that began my path to apostasy. Here it is. Human beings live for a finite, meaning countable, amount of years before they die. This means also that human beings commit a finite number of deeds before they die. Yet, according to Christianity, after a person dies, the person is either sentenced to heaven or to hell for eternity. Eternity is an infinite amount of time. Eternity is forever, and it's not countable. So, how is it fair and just that a person who committed a finite number of sins or deeds is judged to be somewhere for an infinite amount of time? How can God be just when you start considering the concept of heaven and hell? Footnote. So this actually is the question that just confused me so much. Like, I wrestled really hard with this particular question. And it's this question that really started my path to apostasy. This is the question that I'm throwing back to him, and I wanted to see how he would respond to it. It's always a question I ask, and at the time that I started becoming an atheist, I actually asked one of my closest friends this question as well. He ended up being an atheist as well, and he wasn't as, like, you know, I was a pastor's son, so I was like devoutly Christian. He was kind of a more like, you know, I go to church on Christmas and Easter kind of Christian, who really didn't have any solid foundations in the faith. But like, once he you know, I mean, he's been having his own doubts too, but I think this particular question for both of us was just like, holy crap, like, what does Christianity actually mean? So that was what I asked him. I'll continue on with what I read, with what I wrote. Also, here are what I consider some tougher questions. Suppose you end up having a son later in life. It could be a daughter too. You know, you have a family member that you love. Anyway, like a good father, you would love your son, most likely. And then he grows up to have cancer. Imagine this scenario. Before he dies of cancer, he renounces his Christian faith and claims to be an atheist. And he dies an atheist. And then you live out your life, and then you die. According to your beliefs, according to Christianity, your son will end up in hell, and you will end up in heaven. Now, knowing that your son is in hell, do you think you'll be happy in heaven? If you are happy in heaven, how is that logically possible? How is that logically possible when you'll most likely end up in heaven and many of your loved ones, such as your son, will end up in hell? Does that mean in heaven you will be oblivious to the fact that your loved ones, such as your son, for example, are in hell? In that case, God has brainwashed you, and there goes the Christian's oft-repeated free will argument. Does that mean you just don't care about your loved beings in hell anymore because you're now in heaven and everything is awesome for you? Well, then apparently heaven kind of changes your personality. It turns you into a selfish, apathetic jerk because you no longer care about what happened to your son. Your son's in hell, but you're happy in heaven. You don't care anymore. You know, you see what I'm getting? Because this is a footnote again. Because Christianity tells you, you go to heaven, you're going to be happy there. But if you look at the world around you, Christianity, like, one-fifth of the populations are Christians, you know? Almost everyone else are different religions. Muslims, Jews, atheists, Hindus, Buddhists, 5/6 of the people in the planet, according to Christianity, are going to end up in hell. Because they don't believe in Jesus as their only one and only Savior. And it's quite likely that your loved ones, you know, your best friend, your wife or something, I don't know, that's less likely. But let's say your grandpa, your parents, your uncle, your cousin, your son or daughter, they might not end up believing the same religion as you. So, according to your belief, they'll probably end up in hell, according to Christianity. And you'll end up in heaven. When that happens, is it possible for you to be happy in heaven while your loved one is in hell? And if so, how? How is that logically possible? So, I'll continue with what I wrote. My argument here would be that if you end up in heaven and your loved ones end up in hell, then you won't be 100% joyful and happy in heaven. Because if you are still happy, well then, there's clearly something wrong with that picture. Either God took your free will away and made you into a robot, or you've been transformed into someone more cold-hearted than you used to be. So your personality changed by God because you went to heaven. Now, I know you'll be inclined to disagree, but I'm curious to see how you'll wrestle with these kind of questions. So, that was what I wrote him, and these kind of questions are really what drove me to where I'm at now with my set of philosophy and beliefs.